Sri N. Gokulakrishnan.
Honorable Vice Chairman, sir. Thank you, sir. The government has introduced the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Bill 2019, wherein 8 amendments under various sections have been incorporated. The bill deals with 3 issues mainly. First, it strengthens the provisions related to time limits. Secondly, it specifies the minimum payouts to operational creditors in any resolution plan. Thirdly, it specifies the manner in which the representative of a group of financial creditors, such as home buyers, should vote. The bill supports financial creditors and spells out concerns over extensive litigation, causing undue delays in settling insolvency proceedings. The delay caused by extensive litigation goes against the spirit of the code. It may hamper value maximization. The bill also includes suggestions by various stakeholders. If the creditors who have different pre-insolvency entitlements were treated equally, then it would adversely impact the cost and availability of credit. Sir, now it is the need of the hour that all creditors are treated fairly without unduly burdening the adjudicating authority, whose role is to ensure that the resolution plan complies with the provisions of the code. Sir, the bill has proposed a time limit of 330 days for completion of the resolution process, including litigation. If it is not completed within the time frame, the bill proposes to pass an order requiring the corporate debtor to be liquidated under Class A of subsection 1 of section 33. According to this amendment, the rulemaking power enshrined in section 30 of the code would be limited, as it is a matter of procedure and administration and thus indirectly falls out of the scope and ambit of the code. Further, the amendment specifies that those cases which are pending beyond 330 days should be disposed of within 90 days. This will be great relief to the appellants. Sir, it is clarified that the resolution plan will be binding on all stakeholders, including central and state governments and local authority to whom a debt is owed. This is created to bring an effective mechanism for dealing with the non-performing assets. The Information Utilities Regulation enacted in the IBC Code 2016 should be implemented effectively. By doing so, the information relating to the default of a registered user will be processed quickly and the status communicated to the registered users expeditiously. The amendment stresses that the operational creditors receive an amount which should not be lesser than the amount they would receive in case of liquidation. This is a welcome clause and it protects the interests of the operational creditors who now, like home buyers, became financial creditors. Sir, many experts view that the said amendments will bring confidence among the lenders. The amendment is in favor of banks since they are secured lenders and will have primacy in the resolution process. Sir, as far as the admission of insolvency cases initiated by the lenders, the National Company Law Tribunal must determine the existence of default within 14 days of receiving a resolution application. Based on its finding, NCLT may accept or reject the application. In case the NCLT does not find the existence of default and has not passed an order within 14 days, it must record its reason in writing. Thereafter, a committee of creditors consisting of financial creditors will be constituted for taking decision regarding insolvency resolution. The committee of creditors may either decide to restructure the debtor's debt by preparing a resolution plan or liquidate the debtor's assets. Sir, The bill also states that this provision would also apply to insolvency processes in cases, number one, that have not been approved or rejected by the NCLT. Number two, that have been appealed to the National Company Appellate Tribunal or Supreme Court. Number three, where legal proceedings have been initiated in any court against the decision of the NCLT. More flexibility is ensured for applicants seeking resolution. It allows them to include corporate restructuring programs, including mergers, demergers, and amalgamation as part of the resolution plan. Such restructuring would not come under the scanner of tax authorities. Sir, through these 8 amendments, the government aims to fill the critical gaps in the corporate insolvency resolution framework as spelled out in the code. Simultaneously, this also maximizes the value from the corporate insolvency resolution process. It also ensures maximization of value of a corporate debtor, adhering to strict timelines. The overall objective of the government is to achieve the outcomes envisioned in the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. It seeks to ensure speedier resolution of cases involving corporate debtors. Sir, the bill also enhances the powers of the Committee of Creditors to decide on how the claims will be distributed on the basis of commercial consideration. Under the code, as of now, there is no clarity on distribution to creditors other than the financial and operational creditors. The bill would also empower the COC to decide the distribution to such creditors on the basis of commercial consideration. Sir, before I conclude, I would like to highlight 2 issues in the bill. One is, it is yet to formulate and notify rules for proprietorship and partnership firms. That means over 97% of MSMEs are excluded from the vital reform, which allows an orderly resolution of failed firms and an honorable exit for an entrepreneur. Sir, the second issue is, as per the corporate insolvency resolution process, the MSME suppliers are categorized as operational creditors. Because of this, they are excluded from the participation in the entire process under IBC. Sir, 1 minute, sir. There is no statutory protection of their payments under the resolution plan, which is guaranteed at the MSME under MSME Development Act. The unfortunate fallout of the anomaly is that not only the corporate NPS, along with them, a plethora of MSME NPS will also emerge. The government may please examine this. With this, I support the bill on behalf of my party. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Nadri.